After a warm night, it was a hot day, especially in our west. Reached a top of 33 degrees in Penrith, 30 in Richmond and 28 in Campbelltown. While it was cooler along the coast, 22 in Terre Hills and 25 in the city. A cool change moving through southern New South Wales saw milder temperatures ranging from 17 in Albury to 20 degrees in Batemans Bay and Wollongong. In contrast, northern New South Wales was very warm, especially in the far northeast corner. Grafton reaching 41 degrees, their hottest October day in over 50 years. While it was Moree's hottest October day in 4 years, reaching 39. Tomorrow, winds and showers will ease under a high across South Australia, Tasmania and Victoria, while strong southerlies in a trough will cause showers and storms over parts of eastern New South Wales and southeastern Queensland. Brisbane heading for a shower or two tomorrow, 31 degrees, fine and 18 in Canberra. Showers easing in Melbourne, 14 degrees. Partly cloudy and 19 in Adelaide and a fine 24 on the way for Perth. We are expecting some rain to move across the north coast tomorrow. The heaviest falls around Port Macquarie. It will be much, much cooler than today, only heading for a top of 17 in Wollongong and Newcastle, 25 for Grafton, and there is a strong wind warning in place along the entire coast. Get ready for a wintry blast tomorrow. Sydney will be cloudy with a high chance of showers and it will become increasingly windy, especially along the coast in the afternoon and evening, with southerlies reaching 30 to 40 kilometres an hour. If that rain arrives, it will bring 1 to 5 millimetres, heaviest near the coast, and temperatures will be up to 7 degrees cooler than average. We are heading for tops of just 17 to 19 degrees right across our western suburbs, 16 in Terre Hills and Cronulla, and 19 in the city. Plus, there will be a significant wind chill. Let's take a look ahead, and the cool and showery conditions will continue on Friday, heading for 20 degrees, finally up on Saturday, 21, warming up to a sunny 26 on Sunday, with temperatures reaching the 30s again early next week, those overnight lows ranging from 12 to 18 degrees. In our west, a possible shower or two on Friday with a top of 20, partly cloudy and 23 on Saturday, quickly warming back up on Sunday with a top of 30, temperatures soaring back up to 36 degrees by Monday, Pete.
Hello again. Although we're in the middle of spring, Melbourne's weather had all the winter ingredients today. For the city, a top of just 13 degrees, and that came before lunchtime. Shortly after that, the showers arrived, most falling in a short and sharp burst. Docklands had a particularly heavy shower, and like quite a few suburbs, it came with hail. But they were a bit hit and miss. Werribee collected over 3 millimetres, but some suburbs missed out altogether. Most suburbs recorded maximums of 14 or 15 degrees, but temperatures took a dip in the middle of the day, and the fresh southwesterly winds sent feels like temperatures down to low single figures. The southwest of the state had a particularly chilly day. Ballarat and Hamilton only reached 12 degrees. Only the far north and the far east made it into the high teens. The light showers have been confined to areas on and south of the ranges, and the unusually cold conditions brought snow as low as 900 metres. Winds have been pushing up from a very long way south, bringing up that icy cold air, and those chilly conditions will be with us again tomorrow. But the high will edge closer, and by Friday it'll move over Tasmania, sending in some warmer southeasterly breezes. Then temperatures are set to peak across the weekend, so some good timing. Brisbane's temperatures have been peaking this week. It's been in the 30s, heading for 31 again tomorrow, but showers and possible storms are expected to develop later in the day. A top of 24 on the way for Perth, but it'll only reach the teens elsewhere through the south. 19 in Adelaide and Sydney, 18 for Canberra, 14 in Hobart. Back home, it'll be another chilly start to the day for inland areas, with widespread minimums of 2, 3 and 4 degrees. Daytime temperatures will be below average again, but slightly higher than today, mostly the mid-teens through the south and the high teens and low 20s through the north. And there'll only be a few light drizzly showers through the south. There'll be light passing showers across Melbourne overnight. Then they'll continue through the morning, although generally adding nothing more than a millimetre to the rain gauges. It'll be another chilly night, then daytime temperatures will be similar to today, 14 or 15. And the southerly winds will be fresh, making it feel quite a few degrees colder. For Geelong, a low of 7, a top of 15. The city is expected to dip to 9 degrees, then a cloudy top of 14. Things pick up after that. A partly cloudy top of 20 on Friday, 24 on Saturday, but windy. Sunday is the peak of the week, sunny and 26. 23 on Monday with showers developing, a shower or two on Tuesday and 17. 17 again next Wednesday with the chance of a sprinkle. And we're in for another chilly spring day tomorrow. After a low of 9, there'll be a shower or two early on, then a cloudy top of 14 with gusty winds.
And we do, thankfully, Lofty, only very light, but a long line of light showers stretching from around Casino in New South Wales up towards Roma, dropping some much-needed rain. Some around the fire-affected areas where I am this evening, Millmerran, no rain yet, but looks likely we'll all see a drop or two in the coming days. I'll show you the outlook in just a moment. If you have a look at today's temps from around the southeast, an absolute scorcher in the west. Not so bad along the coast, but those cooling sea breezes up in the high 20s for most areas. Gatton today 36, Ipswich 35. Will be slightly cooler tomorrow. Tomorrow's weather map, you can see the trough that's moving over parts of northern New South Wales and us in southeast Queensland. That's going to bring some strong southeasterly winds and potentially some isolated thunderstorms as well as some much needed showers. Interstate tomorrow, showers on the way for Sydney, Melbourne and also Hobart. Fine for Darwin. And back home, fine along the North Queensland coastline. Cooling off somewhat in the west, still up around the mid-30s for the Isa and Longreach, at about 5 degrees cooler tomorrow for Roma than what we saw today. Still warm for Rocky tomorrow, hitting 37, 32 the top for Gladstone, and we could see through the Fraser Coast a possible shower and thunderstorm around Hervey Bay and Gympie late in the afternoon. Here in the southeast, it'll start off much like today was, warm and windy, but by the afternoon we'll have that southeasterly wind change move through, could see some showers, fingers crossed we get thunderstorms as well. Temps getting up to 32 degrees tomorrow for Ipswich and still warm for the sunny coast, getting up to 31. Out on the bay tomorrow, not a lot of fun. A strong wind warning for Gold Coast waters and seas on the bay getting up to around 2 metres. For the city, a top of 31, dropping down to 21. And then have a look at Friday. Could see up to 10 millimetres and a top of just 20 degrees. For Ipswich, again, a cool one for Friday with potentially up to 10 millimetres in the gauge. For the Gold Coast, could see up to 20 millimetres for our Friday, and again, cool temps and showers are forecast on Friday for the Sunshine Coast as well. Lofty, fingers crossed, we get that much needed rain.
Yes, it's getting colder. No surprises about that. It's only 12.6 degrees in the city at the moment, and that was after our pretty chilly top of 15.4 degrees earlier on. Across the suburbs, well, there were a few showers around that also mixed in with that, making it feel a little bit more wintry, especially through the hills, a millimetre or so through there. And the temperatures didn't want to budge. Glenelga nor Lunga only managed 15 degrees, and it was only 10 degrees at Mount Lofty today. A few little splashes on the Eyre Peninsula around Elliston and Coffin Bay, not too much really around there though, and a cold top of 17 degrees at Port Lincoln today. Most towns through the southeast saw a couple of millimetres, but then Nangwari came in way over with almost 10 millimetres there, and it was 14 degrees at Mount Gambier. Right now we're getting these winds from the south that are bringing the cold, but when that high pressure system on the charts there moves east, things will start to warm up. In the meantime though, it is still looking quite shivery interstate as well. Melbourne is showery, 14 tomorrow, and Hobart around that same mark. But look at that, the sunny icons are starting to reappear for parts of South Australia tomorrow as we rise into the low 20s from Port Pirie through to Port Augusta and Woomera. We'll still be more so in the teens through the south with 18 at Nuriutpa and 19 at Murray Bridge, but still it's a noticeable step up from today. On metro waters, we'll see southerlies reaching up to 20 knots north of Brighton during the afternoon and seas around a metre. And then around the Adelaide suburbs tomorrow, it's definitely a noticeable lift with those temperatures tomorrow, up to 20 degrees at Elizabeth and 19 for Glenelg in Norlunga. In the city tomorrow, we're going for that dry top of 19 degrees, partly cloudy conditions and an overnight low tonight of around 7 degrees. Now, after that, well, we'll finish the week with another dose of spring sun, up to 24 degrees on Friday with clear sunny conditions on the way. The weekend looks pretty decent as well with temperatures in the 20s. So on Saturday, we're going for 26 degrees. A little bit of wobbling around with the temperatures, which is certainly what we do see at this time of year in spring. But still 23 degrees to round out the weekend on Sunday. We could see a few light spots to welcome the new week next week, but nothing heavy and temperatures expected to remain around that 20 degree mark. So all in all, a little bit more sunshine in store for Adelaide over the coming days.